The festival was over and the boys were all planning for a ball. The cabaret was quiet except for the drilling in the wall. The curfew had been lifted and the gambling wheel shut down. Anyone with any sense had already left town. He was standing in the doorway looking like the Jack of Hearts. He moved across the mirrored room, set it up for everyone, he said. Then everyone commenced to do what they were doing before he turned their heads. And he walked up to a stranger and he asked him with a grin, could you kindly tell me, friend, what time the show begins? Then he moved into the corner, face down like the Jack of Hearts. Backstage, the girls were playing five cards, stood by the stairs. Lily had two queens, she was hoping for a third to match her pair. Outside, the streets were filling up, the window was open wide. A gentle breeze was blowing, you could feel it from inside. Lily called another bet and drew up the Jack of Hearts. Big Jim was no one's fool, he owned the town's only diamond mine. He made his usual entrance, looking so dandy and so fine. With his bodyguards and silver cane in every harem place, he took whatever he wanted to and he laid it all to waste. But his bodyguards and silver cane were no match for the Jack of Hearts. Rosemary combed her hair and took a carriage into town. She slipped into the side door, looking like a queen without a crown. She fluttered her false eyelashes and whispered in his ear, sorry, darling, that I'm late, but he didn't seem to hear. He was staring into space over at the Jack of Hearts. That face somewhere, Big Jim was thinking to himself. Maybe down in Mexico or a picture up on somebody's shelf. But then the crowd began to stamp the feet and the house lights get dim. And in the darkness of the room there was only Jim and him, staring at the butterfly who just drew the Jack of Hearts. Lily was a princess, she was fair-skinned and precious as a child. She did whatever she had to do, she had that certain flash every time she smiled. She had come away from a broken home and lots of strange affairs, with men in every walk of life which took her everywhere. But she never met anyone quite like the Jack of Hearts. Judge came in unnoticed and was being wined and dined. The drilling in the wall kept up, but no one seemed to pay it any mind. It was known all around that Lily had Jim's ring, and nothing would ever come between Lily and the king. No, nothing ever would, except maybe the Jack of Hearts. Rosemary started drinking hard and seeing her reflection in the knife. She was tired of the attention, tired of playing the role of Big Jim's wife. She had done a lot of bad things, even once tried suicide. Was looking to do just one good deed before she died. She was gazing to the future, riding on the Jack of Hearts. Lily took her dress off, buried it away. Has your luck run out? She laughed at him. Well, I guess you must have known it would someday. Be careful not to touch the wall, there's a brand new coat of paint. I'm glad to see you're still alive, you looking like a sage. Down the hallway
footsteps were coming for the jack of hearts. The backstage manager was pacing all around by his chair. There's something funny going on, he said, I can just feel it in the air. He went to get the hanging judge, but the hanging judge was drunk. As a leading actor hurried by in the costume of a monk, there was no actor anywhere better than the Jack of Hearts. No one knew the circumstance, but they say that it happened pretty quick. The door to the dressing room burst open and a cold revolver clicked. And Big Jim was standing there, you couldn't say surprised. Rosemary right beside him, steady in her eyes. She was with Big Jim, but she was leaning to the Jack of Hearts. Two doors down, the boys finally made it through the wall. Cleaned out the bank safe, it said they got off with quite a haul. In the darkness by the riverbed, they waited on the ground for one more member who had business back in town. For they couldn't go no further without the Jack of Hearts. The next day was hanging day, the sky was overcast and black. Big Jim lay covered up, killed by a penknife in the back. And Rosemary on the gallows, she didn't even blink. The hanging judge was sober, he hadn't had a drink. The only person on the scene missing was the Jack of Hearts. The cabaret was empty now, a sign said closed for repair. Lily had already taken all of the dye out of her hair. She was thinking about her father, who she very rarely saw. Thinking about Rosemary and thinking about the law. But most of all, she was thinking about the Jack of Hearts.